All right, there's tons and tons of different synthesizers and synthesis software out there. And while it's good to make sure you understand the software that you're using, if we can think a bit about the fundamentals of how synthesizers work, then we can approach any kind of synthesis system and have a huge head start. A really helpful way that I approach synthesizers is thinking about categories of modules. I break it down into 5 types of synthesis modules. You can break down any synthesizer into these 5 synthesis modules, and then you'll immediately have a framework with which to interact with it. The 5 modules I list are generators, combiners, modifiers, time-variant controllers, and storers, or really storage, I guess. Generators make sound. These are oscillators, samplers, things that produce the audio for you. Without a generator, you're not going to have any sound. Additive synthesis, wavetable synthesis, FM synthesis, all of the generators in these systems are oscillators. Of course, there are more sophisticated generators, such as in physics modeling synthesizers, but the principle is that these are what are making the initial sound. Next, combiners. Combiners take in multiple audio signals and combine them into one, a mixer, a crossfade, etc. Most synthesizers are using multiple generators at some point, and we need to combine the signal from those generators together to the output. Next, modifiers. Filters, distortion, delay, anything that takes in an audio signal and puts out a modified audio signal. Again, important to understand these categories, because if you step up to a synth that you don't understand, and you're running your modifiers into the output and you're wondering why you're not getting any sound, it's because you have no generator. Next, time-variant controllers, TVCs. These are modules like envelope generators or LFOs that generate control signals. They generate control signals that vary over time, hence time-variant controllers. These are what allow you to have vibrato, different attack envelopes, and fun effects like envelope filters or auto-wah. Finally, storers, places to store information. If you're running a sampler, those samples need to be stored somewhere. If you have a wavetable oscillator, that wavetable needs to be stored somewhere. Now, some people would add to this list input and output. We don't have any way for humans to interact with this system yet, nor do we have a way to get our sound or visuals out. But thinking about the synthesis portion of a synthesizer, I use these 5 categories: generators, combiners, modifiers, time-variant controllers, and storers.